Hi, I'm Bob Berner, one of the support engineers here at Plugable Technologies. Here at Plugable, we're a big fan of Chromebooks, and for those that may not know, Chromebooks are laptops which run Google's Chrome operating system and have become very popular due to being relatively inexpensive and easy to use. Now, while some of the products we make have worked on Chromebooks in the past, like our USB Ethernet adapters, our USB video adapters and docking stations based on display link technology did not work, as support hadn't been added for these devices within Chrome OS by Google. Now, I'm happy to say that is changing, and native support for our display link USB video adapters and docking stations is coming to Chrome OS, and it is available for those with certain model Chromebooks to try out today. So what do you need to try this out? First, you will need to use a model Chromebook that is on the currently supported list. All Chromebooks are a little different under the hood, and support will be rolling out in stages through all the various devices. And as of today, there's just a few models that are supported. We have some links to those in the description of the video. The Dell Chromebook 13 is one of the supported models, and I have the entry-level model of that unit right here. Second, the support for our display devices is currently available within something called the beta channel. Chromebooks can operate within one of three software development channels called stable, beta, and dev. By default, all Chromebooks are set to the stable channel, which, as the name implies, is the most stable. Google also allows you to switch to the beta channel, which includes updates and new features that are getting ready to be released to the stable channel. Now, this channel is designed to help ferret out any remaining bugs before being released to stable. So while things should work as expected, there's always a possibility of running into a bug or two. Now, the dev channel is the development channel, where new features and fixes are first tried out. This is great if you want to be on the bleeding edge of Chrome OS development, but some things may not work as expected. Switching to the beta channel is very easy to do, and we have a link to how to do so in the description of this video. Now, keep in mind, if you do switch your Chromebook to the beta channel and want to switch back to the stable channel, you will have to perform a procedure called a power wash, which will erase any data stored locally on your Chromebook. Now, as most Chromebooks store their information within Google's cloud services, this isn't a problem for most people, but we wanted to call that out just in case. I have already switched over to the beta channel on this unit, so I'm ready to go. I have here one of our UD-3900 dual display docking stations, which allows you to add up to two 1080p displays and provides for six additional USB ports, a wired Ethernet connection, and provides both an audio output jack for headphones and an audio input jack for microphones. I already have two monitors connected, a wired USB keyboard and wired USB mouse, and an Ethernet cable. I don't have to load any drivers or software since everything is now built into Chrome OS. I just have to connect the USB cable from the dock to my Chromebook. Now, the Dell Chromebook 13 has two USB ports. The one on the right is a lower speed USB 2 port, and the one on the left is the high speed USB 3 port. So I'm going to plug the dock into the USB 3 port. Now, as you can see, Chrome OS has extended my desktop across both displays, and now I can use my keyboard and mouse. If I check the network settings, I'll be able to see that I am using the wired Ethernet connection in the dock instead of the wireless Ethernet connection in the Chromebook. Now, one thing to note is that the Chromebook is still running off its internal battery. Our UD-3900 dock cannot charge the Chromebook, so if you need to charge, you still need to use the original power adapter that was included. When I close the lid of the Chromebook, it automatically enters into docked mode and disables the internal display and switches my main display to one of the external displays. When I'm done working at the dock, all I have to do is unplug the USB cable and walk away. So what does all this mean? Previously, anyone who used a Chromebook was limited to one internal display and one external display. As Google has now integrated support for display link devices, you can now add multiple displays using our USB video adapters and docks to help make you more productive. One more thing. The Dell Chromebook 13 is a great laptop, and our UD-3900 is one of our top-selling products, but I would like to give you a little preview of what is to come. We're getting ready to release our new pluggable triple display docking station. This docking station allows you to connect three additional displays to your system, and if that system has the new USB Type-C port, also charge it at the same time. Now, when you pair the new triple display dock with the flagship Google Chromebook Pixel 2015 model that has a USB Type-C port, it allows you to have three additional displays for a total of four, including the internal display, five USB 3 ports, wired Ethernet, and audio input and output, all while being charged over a single USB cable. This takes what is already a powerful laptop and takes it to the next level in terms of expandability. So to sum up, Google's done a great job of integrating support for Plugable's DisplayLink USB video adapters and docking stations, and as of today, it works with a few select Chromebook models on the beta channel. We expect this support to be integrated into the stable channel in the next few weeks. Once stable and as support for other Chromebook devices rolls out, you'll be able to use your Plugable products to extend your already great Chromebook to new levels of efficiency. We hope you've enjoyed this demonstration. Please ask any questions in the comments below or reach out to us directly via email at support@plugable.com. Thank you for watching.
Also known as the UD-ULTCDL, is powered by multiple complementary technologies, but what's especially exciting are the next generation features enabled by USB 3.1 Type-C. So why waste valuable AC outlets by using a separate AC adapter for each one? The C5TX is the perfect all-in-one USB smart multi-charger.